I alone am best.
Oh, I suppose you're wondering why I'm cleaning my gun. Today's topic is zombies. Preferably, what you use to kill them. My choice is AR-15 with bayonet attachment and the drone clip. But what would you use to kill them undead bastards? Seems like I got some work for myself. Style number one is redneck. Although good as in it isn't gonna jam or anything, but you got two shots and you're done. I don't know about you, but when the fuck do you only see two zombies at a time? I doubt this. It's good for fathers protecting their daughters from rapist boyfriends, but not so good about zombies. Feel lucky, punk? Style number two is Western. It does provide a lot of firepower, but the reload is extremely lacking, and that's incredibly important when you're dealing with zombies. And face it, you're only gonna do this if you're going some Rambo and you're going on a suicide to kill yourself. You know, last stand. So unless you're locked in a cabinet and got no food left and there's hoarding zombies everywhere and you happen to have two mighty powerful revolvers, use this style, but otherwise, forget it. Kill them from afar. Style number three is the sniper rifle, or hunting rifle, whichever one you have in your hands at the time. This is extremely effective at taking zombies out before they can get their grimy paws on you to infect you and all that nasty shit. But the downfall is, you need a team, you need friends, and you need good friends. Make sure they don't sneak up from behind or hoard you, because bolt action isn't really going to stop a whole shitload of zombies coming back from all directions. So this style is effective if you get a supporting team or a nice rooftop to hunker down on. Otherwise, you're kind of stuck with leaving this in a dumpster and picking up something like a pistol. Nonetheless, got a rooftop, got some friends, go have some fun, kill some zombies. Style number, I'm just gonna call this suicide. Unless you can use this one shot to shoot yourself, it ain't worth it. Throw this thing on the ground and pick up something with some real bullets. Do a favor, save yourself. Don't touch muskets. If Godzilla was a zombie, this is what you'd use to kill him. Style number five, mega revolvers. This style isn't too bad, but it's weight that catches you. These things are huge, and they're not like a rifle where you can shoot a long ways. Granted, you can shoot further than a normal pistol, but normal pistol, you get like 10 rounds. This thing, you got 6. So pick up one of these if you're planning on facing like a super zombie or some fucking bulletproof monster. Otherwise, I wouldn't recommend this unless you just want to look badass and try to scare the zombies away. May work. Hell, I'll try it. Coup de grace. Shotguns. Best of the best in a zombie-infected shithole world. Amazing at close quarters where zombie situations get the worst. Plenty of rounds in here and you can pump them up pretty fast. You know what you're doing. A lot of different round types, buckshot, slugs, etc. But anything you load in here is going to put down a zombie, simple as that. So if you're looking in a gun cabinet, a bunch of guns laying around, reach for the shotgun. It'll save your life every time. So, let's kill some fucking zombies. Bang, bang, bang. 22s. The only reason I bring this up is because this is closest you can get to unlimited ammo in real life. You hold a lot of rounds with this because, you know what, they're that big. Not the best for killing zombies, gotta be pretty close and you're probably gonna pop them in the head. But there's just an overwhelming amount of bullets you can carry. You could put like 100 rounds into a zombie and still have a million more to shoot the more zombies. So, if you got a little kid, or you just like shoot a lot, use a 22. Why not? Ha! You thought I was over with. I got one more style to show you. Crossbows. Bows in general, at least. Well, extremely slow firing. Not that far range. They got some guns just don't have, and that's quiet. You can be sneaky with these fucking things and kill a zombie without attracting all his dead friends to come chew on you like some kind of fucking taco enchilada. But if it's dark out, or just if you need to take out a zombie without notifying all his friends, use one of these if you got it. Otherwise, you're gonna have to go melee, and I've seen some shit that I don't want to see ever talk about. So, not that bad. Not that bad. Stay right there. Hold on a second. This is the biological weapons. No, I don't mean chemical. Animals. One moment. Man's best friend? Well, in a zombie situation, yes, he is. Train them to sniff out zombies. They'll be able to find them because you see zombies and the zombies see you. It's a perfect situation. You do have to feed them. That's probably enough to worry about a gun for. But if you are stuck somewhere, you can always eat the dog. Puppy chow. Oh, I almost forgot. There's one more weapon out there that you should know about. Kittens. Not very many people know this, but zombies are naturally afraid of these things. Nobody knows why. It must be their cute furry fur or something about them. Fluffiness? I don't know. Maybe zombies don't like chewing on very furry things. But you can just grab a handful of these things, put them in a bag, and possibly just, you know, throw them at a couple zombies. Or at least carry them around. Put a leash on one. Zombies will never come near you. I've tried it. It worked pretty damn good. So maybe if you had a handful of kittens, maybe? You never even need to fire around. Good thought.